amazed in your presence.
I want to be the church of God. No concern, my sin is the name of Jesus. Amen. I want to concern is the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I am really grateful to God. I don't take this opportunity for granted. I want to just start by acknowledging the leadership of this house. See, there are several pastors. I won't be able to mention all of you by name, but can I say all protocol is observed? I want to appreciate you and I want to appreciate this opportunity. I want to especially just thank Pastor Chajwana for inviting me. I've known her for a couple of years now. She's been an older sister to me in the Lord for quite some time now, and I don't take this opportunity for granted. I want to also just acknowledge the apostles of this house. I'm one person who has benefited in the past years from the time I started college. I want to just thank God for them. And it's really an honor and a privilege to be able to minister at a gathering such as this, in this kind of a house. And I want to just get right into that, which we are here for, Maskatanas. As in South Africa, I also want to just acknowledge our good doctor here. I tell you, if I didn't have an engagement like I had from where I was coming from, because I came in just at 1 o'clock, I was a little late, because normally I arrived a little earlier than the time that I should speak. She's one of my favorite speakers in Zimbabwe, so it's quite an honor and a privilege to just sit at the next bench with the hallelujah. I thank God for you, Doctor. You're a gift from God. I hope the Church of God appreciates. Just a round of applause to appreciate the gift of God. Hallelujah. No, don't worship men, but we do honor them. Hallelujah. Which has to do with business. Amen. Amen, business women.
Amen.
General Pakatkana, which is my own marriage, my own business. Wonderful stuff. I trust that you'll have a good time this afternoon. I'm going to speak on a topic which I have entitled Mighty Words Upon the Earth. And Sura Mukarita, as we got to go to Tauran and I. Chanting to Tauran and did 7 to 9. Amen. Chamotara 7 to 9, she could never choose such a canak. Doting that my national, and I've been that to Tanga, she could put. Chaisho, do you want to see who to Zimbabwe? My doctor for 4 times. Father, we want to thank you this afternoon. We thank you, Lord, for your grace upon this place. We thank you for every woman who is in this place, young, middle-aged, old, at whatever level they may be. I thank you, Lord, for the spirit of the Almighty that will come upon us in this place to teach us and to instruct us concerning the things that we see from your word. Thank you, Lord, that you have already put in us a certain kind of might. And thank you that this afternoon, as we get into your word, as we begin to converse concerning these things, you will be there. And we invite you, Spirit of Jesus Christ, to minister to us that our lives may never be the same again. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Couple of months back, Ndakaenda kusangano where I know it's Toastmasters. Now, Toastmasters are a group of people in Zimbabwe who teach people to talk. I've been invited by a friend. One of the first things we were asked to do, was to a box, and offering a basket. I actually offered it as a church. I did it as an organization. We want everybody to put in something. Donation here, and I put our limits in terms of Ungaisa Mari. As Chantu Motondera from that time on, Chakandipa Shungu, is that the person who was in the front, Agarumbeli, Akati Iye, Isa Akomaria Unoda. As who says a dollar, they put a Kusku Church Kunoku. I hope you get that. Now, I'm hoping this afternoon, the way of Sotanevan Ukazi can automate mine who do more than a dollar. Can you speak to your neighbor and say, more than a dollar? Now, a dollar is a start, and I know a dollar may be a lot to someone, because cheaper 5 rand. But I believe God that is a season and time when you and I, as children of God, as sons of God, though we are women, can do more than a dollar, amen. And so I just want to share with us concerning what I call the mighty ones upon the earth. My husband says, I must say, I'm happily married. to one husband. We've been blessed so far with one son. Just tell you a little bit about myself. My background is investment banking. I spent most of my working life and how I'm trained. My training is in banking. But I moved from banking deliberately to pursue what I believe is my passion and my calling, which is enterprise development. So I do two things. I run a financial company, education company, which focuses on two things. Enterprise development, in other words, my small businesses and my startups, kind of my SMEs. But at the same time, I also speak a lot on personal finance. I've got a small book I've published. You don't take charge of your personal finance because makes us lack. So I'm gonna just borrow from some of the elements of the space that I have personal interest in and where I have a passion in and begin to speak to us as the Church of God. More important than all the things I have said is the fact that I'm a born-again Christian, Bible believing, devil, you know, chasing, you know, tongue talking, right? I'm going to read two scriptures and then I'm going to confess a few things concerning mind. The first one is Exodus chapter 1, verse 9. The Bible said, and he said unto his people, behold, the people of the children of Israel are more and mightier than we. And then Genesis chapter 10, from verse 8 put to verse 10. And Cush began begat Nimrod. He began to be a mighty one in the earth. He was a mighty hunter before the Lord. Wherefore, it is said, even as Nimrod, the mighty hunter before the Lord. And the beginning of his kingdom was Babel, and Erech, and Akkad, and Calne, and in the land of Shinar. Amen. Now, how many of us know Marina Tulonamat is a mighty God? Who knows that God is a mighty God? We all know Marina Tulonamat is a mighty God. In fact, the scripture speaks about him, about God's might. It says he is a mighty God. It says that he is the mighty one of Israel. Shokonati, he delivered Israel with a mighty hand. Many times in the word, we see God working in what is called mighty power. And scripture also records what are called the mighty acts of God. So I believe upon a narrow that our God is a mighty God. Now what I want just to share my scat anas is the fact that, you know what scripture says in John 4 verse 17? That as he is, so are we in this world. I want you to speak scripture to someone and say, as he is. Speaking of, you know, the Lord of Jesus Christ. As he is, so are we in the world. In other words, if he is a mighty God, then you and I are already destined for mighty things. Amen. Now, I need to warn you. And so I just want to highlight as I lay the foundation from scripture before I go to the practical things. The fact that we have what are called areas of might. Now you may not have known this with me the first time that someone has said this to you, but can I repeat that you have got an area of might? The Bible shows us a couple of examples. I found this from my Bible study, and I'm going to highlight 8 very quickly, where we see the might of different men in the Bible. The Bible speaks, number 1, of Gideon in Judges chapter 6, verse 12. It says he was a mighty man of? A mighty man of? Very well done. Number 2, it speaks about a man called Boaz in Luke chapter 2, verse 1. And the Bible speaks of him as a mighty man of wealth. Number 3, we find the Bible speaking about a man called Kish in 1 Samuel chapter 9, verse 1, as a mighty man of power. Because we want to get into other things. Just go and check these things out in scripture. We also find number 4, from the portion we've read in Genesis chapter 10, verse 8, the Bible refers to a man called Nimrod, and it calls him a mighty man upon the earth. Number 5, we speak of the man Jesus Christ in Luke chapter 24, verse 19, where the word speaks of him as a mighty prophet. Now, just to add a little few things, I'm sorry, the mighty prophet. I know that in the times we are living in Zimbabwe, there are many who claim to be prophets, hallelujah. There are many who have been called by people to be prophets. But I thank God that no matter what happens, Jesus Christ is the quoted in scripture as a mighty prophet. And so a greater than any man, you know, is amongst us, who is Jesus Christ. Number six, the Bible speaks about a man called Apollos. And Apollos was mighty in? Mighty in words. Or mighty in the scriptures. That's Acts chapter 18, verse 24. Number seven, the word speaks about a man called Abraham in Genesis chapter 18, verse 18. As a man who was referred to as a mighty nation, all by himself, a mighty nation. And the last but not least from my notes here, we've got the word speaking about a man called Moses. In Acts chapter 7, verse 22, reference is made to Moses. And it says, Moses was a man who was mighty in words and mighty in deeds. Now, all these eight by themselves can be a sermon. But that's not what I've come to do here. I've just come to demonstrate the fact that in every one of us, Mwari wakato is a specific might. I want you to confess all by yourself and say, I am mighty. And we'll show you how. We'll show you how. Now, I want you to know that every one of us already has stuff that God has placed in the inside of us. Now, you may not know it, but today we will show you how. That there are stuff that God has already placed in the inside of you. And the stuff that God has placed, now, doctors actually taking a thread in that direction. I was almost tempted to stand up and say, everything the doctor has said is true. And then we pray, hallelujah. But since I have been given a chance, I will take it. I want you to know that all of us already have stuff placed in the inside of them. Basics 5, grade 1. Grade 1, which is a A. 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 O. Alright. I promise you I will finish in time for you to go to lunch before you feel faint. So I'm going to ask you to do a small thing.
I'm hoping, just ask someone.
Asamo, kanari munapasa ipapa oska zire, zireke, chimu uza chukubo na kuiti. Ayo, taurane kani na Kristu ma. Rabu na kutuwa na mkati member. I want to see interaction in the aspect, sitting as threes is still fine. Just talk amongst yourselves. I want to have the confidence, dear woman of God, to be able to see the things you are able to do. Some of you can talk, some of you can dance, but I'm not going to be here.
Whatever you find to do, do it with all your might.
So I want you to know that might can be enhanced. From the scripture, Hans Maxwell chapter 1 verse 9, they actually begin to confess and say, the people of Israel are more and they are mightier than we are. And actually the scripture records how we can be able to progress from strength to strength, from glory to glory. And I want to just submit that we can also begin to move from one level of might to another level of might. How do you enhance your might? What is that? Once you appreciate that, you want to ask yourself, how do I enhance it? How do I make it better? Can I suggest three E's around enhancing our mind? The first one is education. When I go back to school. Now, can't you go back to school? Have you done ever one of your own project? Can I A level? Can I put a degree on it? Well, that is important, but I want you to know that for every little thing you're going to quit, could never not see this one. But there is a certain place where your skill or your might, which is already in you, can be refined, and it. You may find it, could never move, and not going to put a deco, second, I got a E, and it. As you can have a bachelor every week, I don't get an OEM change, and I think we as I'm going to go, could not see this much measure to be additional. I should go negative title my preaching church. Never change to coach. So we're saying it's important that you actually go to a place where you can continue to learn. But also the other E is that exposure is important. Because you can take away. What's the time that you want to know every Sunday? Shakari never meet you, but no Sangana. She wants to take away church when you have a pen. And it's. You know, I'm never to pen up because you make it. I say, let's go on. Let me go to a sensitive lady. When you get a scanner, I want to ask someone to move in your opinion, come on our one chips. Oh, I don't want to know who that. What about tomorrow? What is the better energy? Six, I did. She should have seen the moon. You have to suppose the moon. I can say, walk on, I did. Now, I'm so as a chicken, I don't know. As you know, when you talk about relationships with young people, we then say, it's good to have friends first. So you interact with a whole lot of people.
Can I stop by it? Is that all right? Diana, I'm not going to say that.
Recently, in the past few weeks, I got to be on a what is called an Ampion Venture Bus. It's this worldwide competition where they choose 40 people in Africa, they put you in a bus, then you go through 4 countries, which you work on a project. They're supposed to have a picture at the end. Now, one thing I realized in that bus, we were Zimbabweans, I did a couple of us, there were guys from Botswana, Namibia, Europe, States, my countries are Kawana, but I want to really focus on the Africans. Because one of the things that I feel as a nation we sometimes get wrong is the feeling that, you know, we passed through Botswana. We looked at a particular project, you know, it's my hub, because I do some work in the tech hub. And computer engineering is my technology hub. That technology hub behind the government of Botswana was way better than anything I've seen in Zimbabwe. We moved from there, we went to Namibia, we went to another tech hub, you know, we saw Shashakai Momomo. That thing there was way better than what I've seen in Zimbabwe. Because the community has kept up. We saw some takeouts there. The learning point, and I thank God to actually see that Zimbabwe was on the bus, is to say, guys, I think we have a lot to learn. As now we're not going to go to the bus, we're not going to go to number one in the UN. As you put it in your specific area of mind, if you bake cakes, see how other people are making cakes. If you come so and it, one of them on another question, I just say, not going to start out with the man. Competitive in whatever our area of might is. And the last E around enhancing our mind is experience. The best way to do something, or rather to improve on something, is to do it. I hope you heard me there. We're not going to win a chip or which you're going to tower. I think Ukasa going to enhance. Might EOYO, the education, and it's training here to tell you about Toastmasters, how to get maximum impact, how do you raise your voice and lower it, how do you emphasize points. You may not be able to make money as being a gift or an ability, I just want to marry, by the intention of which Maria could be able to change church. I hope my business is. If you don't get exposure, you may not actually be able to see how best to do certain things. But more importantly, if you don't get experience, it will be very difficult for you to make any kind of money from it. And so we are saying, once we have identified our areas, appreciated where our might is, let's deliberately put a budget. It was really about a budget, and it's last week in May, we said, yes, take a budget, Now, even when you work, budget, you have to go, But it's more important. And I come back to our budget for next year. Because you took time to say to Maria Cat, because of Buddha Cat is shining in this way. Per budget, if I want to complete our nation's online, it is a budget, you're enhancing our might. Can I run our mind? Tell me about Baba. Could you change? I don't know what my mind is saying. It is a budget, re enhancing our might. Why? Because the more you do that, the more you increase, you know, our ability to create income. You cannot make money from it. So, I've spoken about people with passports. But I'm at now and I shall decide. Could never see that the people are taking the entire community to the energy. One day on my passport. And to put it at the how can you believe you go to heaven when right now you cannot even go to Botswana? Where vision is not required. Can I encourage you and offend you and to better works? So, as we enhance your might, also very necessary that you give yourself a chance. Now, I realize that you know, it's never too late to start in the area of might. You can be 20, you may be 80, you may be 91, which is a very popular number in Zimbabwe. But it's never too late to start on the area of might, hallelujah. It's never too late to start on the area of might. Why am I saying that? Because what God has already placed in you, that was the area of purpose. And it's never too late to go in the direction of your purpose. As you are in purpose, as you are beginning to manifest your might, that is where you begin to make your wealth. So give yourself a chance. Now, I know women are very sacrificing. Washington are very sacrificing. I've got a child. Truly speaking, if I had to choose between if I had to choose between an opportunity for myself and my child, the inclination for many mothers, and we salute Rana Mama for this, is to choose the welfare of Mana. can I submit that we can do both? Amen.
Yeah.
We can do both, beloved. And so can I encourage you to say, allow yourself. Because sometimes we look at ourselves and say, give yourself a chance. Speak to your neighbor and say, give yourself a chance. But also give other people a chance. Some of us need to actually learn to give one another more chances. Now, I realize this because I've got a 5-year-old, and one of the things we're trying to teach him is to say, Christopher, when you grow up, you can be anything you want. Not all that example, you know, but I don't want to say in Bolton or mine. She should have said, buy a cooler. I had two more shops of Amos Sugar and Francisco. I did. Never mind, I want to have a man, but you have a man, you have a man, you have a man. If so, whatever, my correction take a bookmark. As I believe, can I make a card? I really don't know now. She probably is a very proud mother. I don't know whether she gave him a chance growing up, but because you and I Taona, the end result of giving someone a chance, can I submit that for our children, for our spouses, or are they called spices with their men? But whichever way, give other people a chance to actually begin to manifest their particular might. So I wanted to say on this point, as I just conclude on this particular point, that we can only go as far as we know and as far as we understand. Kana revelation yako iri diki kule also, which is here one verse, no longer going to open it. Ukawa kuna kutitza recipe wani ima cake, nyango ine potential kuna kuna kama cake saka wani. As sure as ya chocolate cake chet, au bake mchatu. Marie mchatu hawi wani, because mchatu hawi ma chocolate cake, mungu chilo achi, ma fruit cake. So the more we have education, exposure, and experience, the better we can actually begin to make something from our mind. In this day of technology, let's take advantage of technology. There are so many things you can learn by my WhatsApp groups. I repose it. There are so many things you can learn by Facebook. Kwetengo siya, shimwe 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 unnecessary, shimwe kuwa ne chichi. Technology is not evil by itself. It's what we do with it. Hallelujah. And so let's take advantage of shimwe technology. Because I know that technology itself and financial literacy, the two of those things combined, that is the future for business. But in business, kana, we're in business of any sort right now. Receive by Facebook, which is Twitter shakat. And it's over my Facebook page, wow, and my business is yellow. But that's my tongue, but my Facebook. When you bake a cake, don't just bake a cake. Do it under the influence of the Spirit of God. You know, when you begin to sing, don't just sing. Begin to minister literally. The Bible actually speaks, you know, and as we do all things, and it, let's do them, you know, by the action of the Spirit of God. And I want to say, even in business, there's opportunity for us to begin to leverage the Holy Ghost so we can enhance our might and we can begin to do things well. The next thing, we've said A, we've said A. The next basic is E, or A. Income. Once you've identified your area of might, your ability, and you've enhanced it, I want you to be aware, number three, that you can actually make some kind of money from it. Now, one of the things I've learned in my few years in enterprise development is that apana change sa goyuta mobile. Apana, you can make money from anything, literally. You know, some of us like to talk. Now, I'm not a fan of doing this, but I've done weddings a few times, or I've done, you know, being at a little ceremonies at a corporate function, and you can actually make money from that. But I can't go to MC. You made what? 600. Ah, now I put some judgment. I really wish I'd come from that one. That's a very good thing. Had $600. As a matter of fact, I'm not down. And so sure my MC was in the better MC in chat. Epsilon is only a master answer me as a shabby say. Rent out for Asia. I want to tell you, rent out for Asia to MC. Muno had an appreciation of their might. Look, I know I'm going to practice and it's actually in the gift. And I'm one of the people who does this. Half the time you borrow jokes from other MCs. So half the things you are saying there, you didn't even originate them. Why should you talk to me? And it's, then you all want, I said, you know, church, actually, $600. $600, I'm going to shit it, I'm going to wait. Who wait and wait, shit it. What you want, I love it, Kupinda. What are you going to talk to? I'm going to go, woo! I'm going to go, I'm going to go, I'm going to the guy tell me about the Makashandis, as far as I got $600, Yekuti mimi muite morali. Inawe kuti munhu akanzwisa kuti income can come from my area of might. I want us to have a certain mindset here. A certain mindset to know that as we identify our areas of might, we can literally make something from them. So anything can be monetized. We can make money from talking. We can make money from trading. I can see my exhibits, which is a good thing. We can make money from trading. But also can I encourage somebody who actually also goes to work and say, I was one of those people who used to talk about work, you know, in a negative way. She said, I'm not choice, which is true. As can I say that your job is actually one of your streams of income. A child of God must have many streams of income, just like the river that flowed through the Garden of Eden, you know, in the beginning, it actually would part in four different ways. As a minimum, I believe as a child of God, you must have at least four streams of income. Maybe we'll speak about this on another day. But the point is to say, in whatever line of chichaunaita, where it is your ability, where you have enhanced your might, you must know that there's opportunity to actually make something from it. And so, you want to ask yourself, whatever it is you do, good name, let us say, I could be an MC. I can be a motivational speaker and be paid for it. If I bake cakes, I could start making words on a commercial cakes on a commercial basis. Begin to say to yourself, how do I create income from it? Now, for those of you that like to read, there's a book which I would really encourage you to read. Robert Kiyosaki, wrote Rich Dad Poor Dad. It's an entry level book on, you know, financial literacy. But I like the fact that I don't for him. But it's a cash flow quadrant. What is it? Number one, either you are an employee, right? So your money comes because you're champion every month. Or number two, you are self-employed. Mnanenga ni doctor, for example, anenga ni sejali yake. Marino pina kaneta say, akanakano shande shande marino yadi, yove ya pinda. Which are a good start. But you better be what is called a business person. A business person is someone who owns a system. In other words, aripo or asipo, marino ngechi pinda. Shafane marino ngechi, ane shop yake, and it. Whether aripo, as soon as fana uchine some shop, marino say, iliku pinda. And so, that's another way of actually making money. Then finally, he says, you know, you can what is called an investor. An investor is a person who puts money actually works for them. Yeah, I don't want to my money. Money every day, I don't get going my money. I'm going to run a book around the security anger. And it's more than a week when you watch it. $10, more than a cheap, rich dead poor dead. It's a very simple book. I know it's sent by an American, but the simple things that are in there really can change your mind. Can I have a good man? Nobody can go around and pay $2. So, and it, you know, the learning point is this, that any area of might can make you some money, but you must begin to sit down and actually begin to say to yourself, now one of the things I realize, particularly with us Africans, which is overrated or underrated rather, is this thing which is called thinking. I want you to ask your neighbor, when was the last time you not think? When was the last time you really sat down to think? And this, yet for any kind of enterprise, there is a level of patience that is required. Have you noticed my stories which we tout? Success stories. Have you ever asked yourself how old those stories are? How old is Econet right now? It's less than 20 years, isn't it? In fact, Econet is a teenager, should be about 15 or 16 years. You know, at its height, for your tinkers to Afrasia, how old was Kingdom when they're talking about it? Close to about the same age. How old is African Sun? Close to about 15 years as well. It's because Panamuno Akatura Mwebuti, Ataka is an enterprise, and Akumira did it. Don't keep thinking, how can I innovate it? I wonder what would have happened if Econet had stuck to just selling lines. Then I'm cutting no marketing ball line. I'm cutting some more. I'm cutting a line selling. Taka charging $140. It's just my line at $2. But it's just they don't make their money only from that. They make it from other things. Those same principles that work for a big business, I'm a dang, work for a small business. Ukana business is cheap. Ska buni ni. Ashna buru imkati. Ashna kana chokolo shufuye. Ina yote mwa chokolo chori chini. Discipline yokarapasi and really think through something and say, okay, my business is cakes. How do I make money from this thing? Who is my client? Who is my target market? How much can they afford? At which time of the year? How often? What is working? What is not working? I know I'm saying boring things. What are the things that make businesses work? Thinking. Can you speak to your neighbor and say think? Very, very important to think. So income can be made from anything. I'm winding up just now. Number four, and I want to emphasize on this one, is to say organize yourselves. Organize yourself. What do you mean by this? You see, many of us, we've had great ideas, a business. Rashid Jada, as far as I can tell, and I'm not even saying this by the Spirit of God, I know that Zimbabweans are enterprising, particularly Zimbabwean women, isn't it? Yeah. Even if I did not, just say amen. You know, I know that many of us have had ideas or have ideas. But you know what kills ideas? Share out. Chat. It's as simple as that. Now, I'll tell you a story of how I started up my small business. Now, at some point, I felt I should leave banking because I could really tell, thank God, that the banking said I was going in a certain funny direction. But also, more importantly, I felt I was bored with that shit. And I was tired of corporate finance and asset management and whatnot, and handling other people's money and making it grow. I was more interested in saying, I'm going to have something just to marry a dick. Didn't anybody tell me to marry you? You could just marry you. It's just a family that is our belief. We believe that Christians must make much money. And when you've made much money, you must put as much as possible towards the gospel. Very, very important. Now, one of the things that I then began to learn at that time was, you know, the way I started was, when I finished at the last bank I was working at, I gave my notice to another Simka, and by then I had already registered a company. So this was, you know, 3 years later, the company was not using it. And I then started doing what I was doing. I went out and told a few people, look, I now do financial education, etc., etc. My first large contract, which was my first big break, was work which I did for United Nations. How I got to do this work, it was not because I was the best amongst the people. If anything, I was the least experienced. In the 99 experience, watch, banana right leader for that work. But what gave me that particular contract was the fact that I'm much of as big as they were and experienced as they were. I was not experience. Chit.
Account, I'll put money in a brown envelope.
And so can I encourage us as Christians to say, I know we may say that we will take the kingdom, we will build mighty businesses, you know, we will influence nations, but you can't do all of that without formalizing your business. Yeah. And so can I say to those of us that are in business, let's make it a goal in the coming year. Amongst losing weight and eating health, let's ensure that we register our businesses. Amen. Yeah. Number one, even a PPC. PPC, my husband, one is shy. Now, I should not say that my business, no matter how small. But she said, ah, you know, my company, no jura. I know company, $300 may be a lot to pay. Can I talk about Kutanga? But when it comes to private business, corporation, I'm going to pay detail by detail. I said, I'm going to talk about my consultants, I have a touch my company. Would you want to zone your PPC? Okay, it will not cost you more than $30. And it's actually acceptable even from Zimra. You can register EOL, they'll register you for checks. So register your company. And it, give your enterprise, no matter how small, a name. Whether I'm a banana, gachile nezita chinicho, warutu hao shepeti nisho, ichinzi wo glorious betting, fashions, you know, let it have a name, let it have his documents, let it have his bank account. Mwana cha iye pano sharo. Mwaza, shino makisa, can you say it's street language, shino makisa, kutumana sharo anasi, travel for mwana next week, ananzani, ananzi baby, travel to next week, ananzani, actually ananzi baby, and it's, a month later, ananzi nana, and it's, kuti business rinzi la serious. Rinoda ostarari. Zere ari kuti achati rolejestiwa kambani. Kambani yako yoenda kuzimura yo register tax. Kana register tax yoenda zvakare yoni yonovhura chi bank account. Panobudawo matenda hapadivi ndivi. Panoda mapepa handiti. Saka madzi angu mukore unouya handizogadza chi mapepa yedu. Tora munoadzana wako kuti gadzisa mapepa. Usabva useza ingoti gadzisa mapepa shamwari. Kuti business rikure, rikuita zvinhu zvinoshamisa. Teacher zvinoshamisa muchurch monk space, I'm gonna say, kuivaka. So, you cannot play in the big league unless you are formal. Very, very important. Get branded as well. And it, make sure that the building gets, you know, the business gets branded. You must have some nice colors, a nice logo, a website, you know, some form of online presence. Show us that you are serious about business. And we trust that, you know, it will grow. So, very, very important. And then the last thing, which is who, because you said R is a, appreciate your might. E is enhance your might. I understand that income comes from the area of might. O, organize yourself. The last one, this one you must say it in short, so that it really hits home. Who stands for these five things? Usa mire. Usa tsuke shure. Usa nete. Usa gaye. And then usa nime. Let me speak quickly to each of these. Usamire, consistency is key for any kind of business. In 2008, I take some suits. Novare 2009, I took a session, but I'm not taking some boots. Novasia 2010, I can't say I'm a boat. A boat, but I'm not taking a hook. Nova, I'm not a job. You know, and then presently, she says, "My opta, my position, my saga." No, don't can I say, beloved, that you cannot grow any kind of business unless you're actually consistent in it? Yeah, right. Now, I know it sounds boring, but you guys, you are Christians. Some of you are married. You've been married to one partner. So what's the problem when it comes to business? Be consistent, man. But that I found you, I'm some suit. I can say regular after a year. You find it from an item chat. Good. Where you are? One of my suits. I'm not in a suit. Sometimes I'm gonna challenge us as I close this afternoon to say some of us need to go back and just revisit older ideas and see whether if we take them up and do it right and formalize and are consistent, whether it will not work. There's a book I read a couple of years ago by a gentleman called Malcolm Gladwell, which is called The Outliers. I highly recommend the book. The bottom line of the book, you know, is he says good about it. He says, I don't excel in anything. You will find that if you go back into their histories, they have spent a minimum of 10,000 hours doing that thing. If you do the math, it translates roughly to about, you know, about 5 years. Now, can I ask you, what business are you going to do in the business? Why did 10,000 hours double? Have you done time in it? Anything you know for focus, it will grow. Can you speak to your neighbor and say, if you focus on it, it will grow. So consistency is important. Focus is very important. Traction comes from what is called compounded effort. The more you keep doing something and hitting at it, the better you become at it, and the more it grows. I'm gonna finish by these two things. The first one is what I call the parable of the free seed. And then I will speak about Usani Metropata Peter Shin Baskatanas. One won't jump. As much as I don't know, family lives such a mess about Zanya. So, I think we'll cancel that today and just continue in prayer. Now, kids. Okay, the parable of the free seed goes like this. Then I have a 12 visit, I don't know. Urupana Bakatpenu, Unos Yankas Memoir, to a couple of free seed. Chakuka was still the Mauk, Uripaulima. Such a shako, Umano Marimon Takamoji, Wakamo to a free seed. She was still the Roko, Kotrajina Mai. Dukona Roko. Makabo to a free seed. Now, Amata, the free seed are in more moving, never will have nature and it. Can I take a free seed to that pair? Rera Kalans. Katara to my name, which is name. Rera wait and it. Regarding the president, I should name the free seed like a Tamari Chuku. I should name the free seed like a Tamari Grimmy. Kana orange, kana yellow. Kana first is chins, and I so new. Look, Marachi, white. Whether I'm a purple, kana blue, kana orange, kana green. But not a free seed, I'm a new one, Emma. So, Nagara would be white. Then you own any type of another business, Edu. If we select at least one idea, Yatino Shimera Nayo, Tichi Shishina, Kushikaya Chenya Ruka Kuma free seed, Ranua Nemajo. So, beloved, actually, this is a challenge to all of us. That is the name Kulemukuya and it. Mapitakacha Tanga, Mapitakacha, Kushama, business Nako, how far in terms of she referring to physics are new? Kanauka Katu physics are called light green. Usami and it is our emoy. Kana physics are called pink. Usami and Shakari and it. Continuing that thing. And to have a point, Ranyato Cheneruka, because you've really been consistent in that line of business. And as we do that, we will find that we will do well in our particular businesses. But as a last thing, why are you and I, as children of God, encouraged to be in business? I'm going to end on the same note that the doctor ended on. To say it's not because we want to gather things unto ourselves. Now, one of the things I thank God that we are able to realize by the grace of God is that, you know what? There's a place for eating things, but you know, you can only eat so much food. You can only, and even heaven, I want to say, you only wear one at a time. Hallelujah. And yet, the more money we make and put into the gospel, the more we can actually begin to impact lives. And so, I believe that when we make money, the internal desire of God is that what we make can actually cause the gospel to go forward. Amen. Live simple lives, eat the things that you want to eat, dress the one you want to dress, but also let us invest in the eternal things. Where we cannot go, let us send money. I'm also vangera and it. As you can marry my vangera, let us say, Runenda me, take a shaka, let's take a vangera, and let's take a vangera. Runenda me, let's take a vangera. And so I want to challenge each and every one of us and say, let us be church builders. Amen. Can you speak to your neighbor and say, be a church builder? What do you mean? I'm talking about both two things on the physical level as well as the spiritual level. You and I can be a part of what God is doing in building this particular house. Amen. But also, we can begin to build the greater sea, the greater church of God, by putting in money towards the gospel. Where we cannot go, let us send money. So, as we begin to start, finish this particular year, let's go home, let's revise these principles, let's ask ourselves difficult questions, and let's begin to make sure that in the coming year, 2015, amongst every other resolution, we tell ourselves, it's a marriage. And the Karachi Kwacha marriage, what a show. Turayako, as is Ziasha Kare, which could lay a bamboo a man. You should never be treasure, and Nakawaku and Zerei in the next bad day, we had to get a marriage, Tivake, who are bamboo a man. Amen.